We're good.
My name's Jamie Kalunga, and I just remember, I recall a time that I helped the outreach and all the homeless that to go move down to this side of the island, and this was going to be the last place that they pushed them to go and live. And so now that they're kicking them out of here, it's a shame. It's, a lot of these people don't have anywhere to go, like myself, you know, but things will work out. Just got to pray for the best.
How do you feel?
Hope that they stop pushing them, you know.
How do you feel about how the city's been treating the residents and the property?
I think it's election year, and I think people got to make points like they normally do, and that's why it's happening, you know, and that's unfair to the people who are, I mean, this is their life, this is how they live, so that you can always be kicked out of it is not, they're jealous because they're down here living on beachfront property and not paying no rent, you know, and I don't know, tourists come down and complain that, oh, it looks a mess. It doesn't. A lot of these people, not all of it looks a mess. Maybe some of it, yes, but you have that in houses. You have that everywhere, and they're not getting kicked out of their house, so, you know.
Has the city made any real attempt to come down and help out or at least clean it?
Shelter. No. We put the rubbish where they tell us to put it, and they take, like, months before they pick it up, so it's not all their fault, you know.
So meanwhile, the people who are trying to clean out their homes are doing what the city asks, and they're refusing
to come pick it up,
which makes it look...
They're not complying to what, you know, they're getting paid to do, and they're not doing it, so, I mean...
And it comes back on you, and they say you're dirty, right? That's how that works?
And they think that everybody that lives down here is on drugs, which is not so. And not to mention, they're poor, you know, I mean, so how are they getting the drugs? It's because it's coming from them. Bring down here because they're poor. They're going to take it, sell it, and make money off of it. But that's not they're not the ones that's bringing it.
How long have you lived down here?
I've been here for about a year.
For about a year.
Yeah. It's really hard. It's hard for a lot of these people, and they're trying. You know, they're doing their best to do whatever they can do just to get on in life, and they're shutting them down all the time. It's sad.
Do you know where you're going to go from here?
Myself, no, not really, but we'll find
somewhere. Do you have any form of transportation to get you out of here?
I have a truck right now, but it's not working, you know, so I gotta work on that too. I gotta get it running. You know, a lot of these people do, they don't have transportation, they're on feet. They expected them to just get out. And
the nearest town is like 3 miles away, right? It's a long hike with your stuff.
And they're depending on other people to be here, you know, and it's not always they could have this time, or, you know, you're waiting on other people's time, and that doesn't always work out either. But just gotta hope for the best. You know, Hawaii's supposed to be, this is what it's all about. You come down here, you go to the beach. When I was a kid, I could go to any beach and stay there.
Anything else you'd like to add? No.
Thank you.
So.
Oh, get the puppy out of the road!
This is the remains of their home. The government signs that say they're not allowed to be here, even though this is Crown land.
Good job, dudes.
So, the city's on lunch right now.
I think they're back.
But it looks like they're heading back in. Continue to walk around and talk with the people of Keaʻau, and I'll be back.